Hello, good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to my Formula One 2020 My Team Jacob Palermo. This is episode number 47, and we're at the Vietnam Grand Prix for the third season in a row at the Hanoi Circuit. Now, if you guys and gals have missed the previous one, which was the Bahrain Grand Prix, be sure to check it out on youtube.com/speedjacobinator3. Also, you can check twitch.tv/speedjacobinator3 for all of my full live streaming coverages with NASCAR Heat 5 and also WRC 9. And if any new subscribers come along, welcome to my new channel and enjoy my magnificent show. If any new followers, be sure to click on the purple heart bell, purple heart, and then follow me or subscribe me into my channel at twitch.tv/speedjacobinator3. And that's the same description in my YouTube channel.com/speedjacobinator3. Well, after a very close finish in the Bahrain Grand Prix, beating out Valtteri Bottas by about 8 car lengths over him at the end of the race, we pretty much be going into the same situation in the Vietnamese Grand Prix, and we have done a great job in practice. My teammate Perez was the fastest in practice in the first practice session, and then the last two practices, then I finished it off with a minute 36. I had a minute 36.955 on the medium, on the slower tires, and then the soft tires, I was a minute 36.039, and then I raced it up a little bit, a minute 35.485 in practice session number 3. So we should be able to get 1 minute 34, or maybe early a minute 35 here at the Hanoi Circuit. And I'm really getting the hang of this this new circuit here in the Vietnamese Grand Prix, and this is my third season of it. I was runner up in the first season, and then one last season by a mangled finish over Lewis Hamilton. But let's see how I can do this time here at the third season of the Vietnamese Grand Prix. So here it is for episode number 46, and the weather forecast is going to be partly cloudy throughout the race. So it would pretty much be the same scenario as it was last season. Qualifying would be sunny and then partly cloudy and then partly cloudy throughout the race, and no rain to worry about inside in the Hanoi Circuit. So here we go for episode number 47 of the Formula One 2020 My Team JPO Career Mode. Here is the Vietnamese Grand Prix in our third season. Hopefully my YouTube goes through, because I had NASCAR Heat 5 running yesterday, and I ran 3 hours and 2 minutes, and the whole thing didn't go as planned, but it should be able to go through this time, and of course there's no interruptions for your YouTube subscribers. And then I cannot wait until a month and a half until we have our new console coming up with the X Series X. Remember, pre-order will be coming up in a week and a half. But the console, my new one, will come out in the next couple of months, and I just cannot wait for it, because these are my last days of this old console. And they see me ready to go and ready to pounce it out here at the Hanoi Circuit in Vietnam, Grand Prix. Let's see how we can do in the first qualifying session. So let's see what the time to beat will be. And it could be the Mercedes cars as usual up front. Well, we got the Ferraris up front. Look at minute 35.783 already for the Red Bulls. So it's Hamilton, and look at my teammate, Sergio Perez, gets a minute 34.941. So here we go. Let's see, and there's our start and price. We're back to that main team. We made the sponsor decals a little more bolder and a little bit more brighter so people could see our sponsor legitimately more better. There we go with that hard left turn. here's the longest, this is perhaps the second longest straightaway trend. It's not as long as the Athabasian track. We are fast in the second sector. Looks like we handled the hairpin turn a little bit more better. That is terrible. I think I got off of the throttle a little bit slower. And it puts us in the P3, and Lewis Hamilton is in P2. But this is only the first qualifying session. We had a minute 35.437, a bit slow. It was a bit too slow out there, but we got to get it a little bit more faster. I was able to be faster in that sector, but then I got a little bit too slow. That's Sergio Perez got the fastest in the first qualifying session. Let's see what happens in the second. And my teammate Perez, he is having a great start so far. Trying to build his team up and try to get that constructive title throughout the season. And both times, man, he gets a little bit faster, maybe 34.887. In the second sector. It's still slow going into the final sector. We got to get it picked up over there in that final sector over there. Or otherwise, we're not going to get the pole position. But we did pick it up a little bit. It was a minute 35.327. And we're down into P4 because Sergio Perez has just taken his last-minute lap, and he got a minute 35.061. And Valtteri Bottas is still sitting at 34.887. But this is where the final qualifying session counts. So we're down into P4, but we can get it a little bit more quicker if we can try to avoid the aprons. If we could avoid the aprons and get off of them, we could get to a quicker speed. Alright, here we go. Final qualifying session. And this is where it counts right now. Yeah, we're seeing some beauties out of the Mercedes AMG, and they're still quick. Didn't get enough room when I was going through there. I was trying to be quick, and then it told me I get damaged to my wing. No, it's not going to do it. It's too slow. So I'm going to have to settle with the P4 over here. And I try to get my car faster, and then I just kept hitting too much on the apron. At least it was a bit quicker. And I get a P4. So we're going to start on row 2, but at least I'm ahead of Bottas and everything, but I'll be starting in P4.
Make sure to join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.
And Lewis Hamilton, look, he is cruising along with his Mercedes. He got a minute 34.699, but we got a minute 35.276. So I was a bit slower that time, but let's hope we can try to make it up front and then try to beat him. It's not going to be an easy task here, but we didn't qualify as fast as we used to be, and then suddenly the car just went a bit too slow. But when we have those R&D developments in the next race in the Chinese Grand Prix, we'll be much faster. I just didn't pick up the pace too much. I just kept hitting too much of the apron, and then it slowed my car down. It looks like we're going to have an interview from Claire.
Please help you.
Well, we're just trying to wait for our ultimate upgrade to come along, but that will happen in the next race at the Chinese Grand Prix. So, well, when we have them done, then it will be a bulletproof pass. Yeah, I just scraped the wall there. I was trying to go a little bit faster, and then suddenly I scraped the wall a little bit, and then this just wasn't enough time. So we're going to end up starting P4 here at the Vietnam Grand Prix. So we were a little bit on the downside on this track and everything. We've been fast during practice, but we were happy about that. But then qualifying, this is not the way it counted. We got our claims up a little bit, 21, but we can get even more quicker if me and Perez step it up and do a good job. So let's see how we can do here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix, and I'm starting P4 in this race. We are ready to go for episode number 47. We're just trying to make sure the race is going to be a partly cloudy kind of a day here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix. So here we go. Episode number 47. Let's see if we can try to go from fourth all the way to the lead and try to keep the pressure down on the Mercedes-AMG pressure knob. So here we go. 55 laps of the Vietnamese Grand Prix in our third season running this race. Here we go. Let's see if we can make it two seasons in a row.
Great circuit, hopefully creating plenty of passing opportunities.
see them take a more aggressive approach today to make up for the compromised start.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look
starting
at
the Vietnamese Grand Prix. We're starting P4 in the race, so I'll be starting right on the outside alongside with Sergio Perez, as Max Verstappen and Lewis Hamilton are in the front row. So I'll be starting right behind Max Verstappen. Let's take a look at the race direction. Everybody is going to be on the soft tires in the beginning of the race. Only one driver is doing the medium tires, and it's one of the Williams cars. And here's how the strategy is going to be. We're going to put maybe 58 and a half laps of fuel, so that way we can have a little more bite on it. And the race will last for about an hour and 30 minutes. And we're going to go with three soft tires. If they go with that strategy, then if we go with the longer strategy, if we go like 15 or 30 laps, then on lap 45, we can go with the medium tires for the final time. So if we do it like that, then that'll be our selected strategy, and then we can beat them throughout this race. So here we go, getting ready for our formation lap here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix in our third race of the season here at the Hanoi Circuit. Let's see if we can wipe out with the Mercedes once again like we did in the previous race in Bahrain. Here we go to get ready to roll off in the formation lap in our Stars and Stripes Team Table Fantasy Organization car. Starting right ahead alongside my teammate, Sergio Perez. Hope he has a good race today, and so do I. We want to really look for our second 1-2 finish for this team. Let's see how we go there. You can see P5. What a good job for Max Verstappen at P2 in the Red Bull Honda. So we have Mercedes, the Honda, and then the rest of them are all Mercedes. Remember, that's a rental in the P6. This is what's been my trouble turn right here, this turn. Here we go. wait for the rest of the grid to come along. There's 22 cars in the field. They see all the back markers coming in, and they're gridding up, and then two's out for the mail cars. There are now the back markers running 21st and dead last. Here we go. Five red lights coming on very shortly here for this Vietnamese Grand Prix, the third running of this race. And it's like, we are underway here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix, and I get a good start. And I go right up into second place. Here comes Hamilton. Can I get around him on this turn? And I do get around him on this turn. Yes, I do. He's still there. And I take the lead here in the Vietnamese Grand Prix. So I go from fourth to first with a great start. Hamilton, almost about 2 seconds. I'm doing very well. I'm going into the S's and going into the Hanoi sector. But the S's have been working out very well today. Oh, 1.5 seconds. I got a little bit slow going into the hairpin left. Thank you. Grand Prix. Standard next to sooner or later shortly. So that way we can save the fuel. Thank you. seconds I have. And it gained a little bit of ground there on that. Now it's 8 seconds at 2.8 on fast straightaway speed. Amazing start so far here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix. They both are running in third, and he's stopping. Lorenz is still holding on in T5 over Carlos Sainz. Position here, 3 seconds ahead of the first Hamilton. Hamilton started still running a little too fast. That's why he was the most of the race. He proved that he still has an even fast speed than Magnus did. But I'm going away from him just a little bit. Remember that pit window is going to be on lap 15 instead of lap 13. So nobody's pitting yet. So it's 27 minutes into this race, and Lewis Hamilton is now pulling away from him about 3.5 seconds. Lopez is still running here about 6 seconds ahead of him. Seconds ahead of my teammate, Sergio Perez, who's currently running in P5 right now. He's still having a good race, but he's running a bit unstable here in the Hanoi Circuit. Verstappen is still running in P4 at 9.7 seconds, but he is still slowing down. Hamilton now goes into the pit. Remember, I won't pit until the next lap. Hamilton does pit. And Perez is up in third. And me and Perez have not pit again. It looks like Perez is on the same strategy as well. Level, so not doing so good here in this class. 15 seconds ahead of Albon, but I'm 19 seconds ahead of Hamilton. I'll still be in first place, but remember, Albon will have to sit on the same lap as I am. I might be keeping a 19-point advantage, so before I go into the pit. Right here on this cloud. So here I come. Yeah, I'm just trying to get into the game with Kirby. Now we're on the pit, so that means save the fuel. So here's our first round of pit stops here, changing over to the soft tires. Now we have the very first pit stall right up in front of us, and here we are. Oh, and Hamilton around me. Oh my goodness, Hamilton. But I'm trying to come by. Here I come. Had a bit of a slow pit stop. See if I can try to get around Hamilton. This is a battle for the battle for that position. Here we go. Ooh. Pulled away a 2.3 second lead. We're talking to Tony in third. Russell is fourth, and both have to pass on the P5, and he has the media. In a minute, 39.673. So Sergio Perez is still running a P6, trying to wait for George Russell to go into the pits in the racing point car. I already got a 3.8 second advantage over Lewis Hamilton. After 18 and 55 laps, it looks like his tires are more wore out than my tires. And I'm still continuing to pull away. Remember, I have 2 laps fresher tires than Lewis Hamilton. This is why it's giving me a great advantage. And remember, during practice, I spend less time on laps than Lewis Hamilton did. And this is what's making the difference in the race. Only 4.8 seconds. He's losing momentum right now. Looking for Max Verstappen. He's closing in on Lewis Hamilton. Come out for P2. You saw him pull a thing going into the hairpin. Thank you. 2 seconds. I hope Hamilton didn't break his wing when I tried to pass him. I didn't hear any contact. He is losing valuable time over Max Verstappen. Perez is now back in the P5. And Verstappen now gets around Lewis Hamilton, and Max Verstappen is now in P2. I have now got a 5.5 second advantage over Max Verstappen. He's just around Lewis Hamilton for P2. Lewis Hamilton is now dropping to P3. Valtteri Bottas could be getting around Lewis Hamilton for P3. He has lost a lot of ground there. I think he's still racing. He must have a broken wing on the star. Maybe the star is making run a little bit of an engine issue on there. He's 9.7 seconds. Maybe you used up the soft tires too much. And meanwhile, Sergio Perez has already closed in on Valtteri Bottas. Stop, it's going to be on lap 30. So we're going to continue to go along with the soft tires. We're going to go to the medium there, because that will last for about 25, 26 laps. And Perez has already gone around both sides, and Perez is now in P4. And he's closing in on Lewis Hamilton to P3. He's stopping at 6.3 seconds ahead of me. And now Lewis Hamilton is continuing to lose a lot of ground. He's only about 3.8 seconds ahead of my teammate Sergio Perez, who is about to take the podium spot away from Lewis Hamilton. Well, it looks like I got the better tires up for this race, so better than the Perez's car. Traffic. I got on the first car, that is one of the low volumes of shoe fields, so it looks like the Alfa Romeo racing has moved up in the field. Mm-hmm. none of my women's Williams class had to go to medium tires in the first set. I think that was such a bad idea. Well, Dr. Wilson was losing ground on those medium tires. He took only about 15 seconds. Now goes into the pit. See what he puts in. And both guys also get to the same time as well. It looks like they just got a medium tire, but came out. fourth play. And Chris Salvatore Botas out of the fifth lane. He just gets another great pit stop. That was a nice pit stop by Sergio Caro. Still put on the soft tires, and everybody else goes into the pit. Basically, Lopez is trying to get around the Bastian Ocon for P5. Looks like Lewis Hamilton has changed his wing on his car, and he lost so much distance at the end of the race. Try to be off the stop and off the pit. Stop him, gets around the stop him, gets him back. Minutes into the race, and all 22 cars are still running out there. This has been a competitive race so far, so good here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix. 21 seconds ahead of the stop, and we have another pit stop to come in on this lap. Second round of pit stop, and we are going to change over to the soft tires, and then we only have one more spin to go, and then we'll be at lap 45 on the final 11 laps of the race on mediums. And both guys are still out there with the mediums, but they're running on the same lap as everybody. I think you'll take the soft tires in the next lap. Here we go. Stopping now takes the lead, but remember, I'm going into that nice straightaway going through, and I do pass to Stopping. I think Lewis Hamilton could be running in P7, and he is the fastest car out there. And I just got out of the pit at 3.2 seconds. I had us to stop it. So I'm running 3 laps pressure tires than Max Verstappen does. Hamilton has a change of lane on his car. He was running in P6. And Perez is running in 4. And that's the rest of the field. Thank you. with one last arena here in the Vietnamese Grand Prix. Thank you. That's a Red Bull car on Max Verstappen. And Team Ventura, he's doing a good job. He's running in P3 right now. Losing a little bit of ground. He's about 3 seconds ahead of Lewis Hamilton. Lopez is 25 seconds. So we're going to have to pit right now until lap 44. Into the race. Laps are winding down here at the Vietnamese Grand Prix. 3.7 seconds. We are pulling away from Max Verstappen. It looks like that little stick graph help is helping close in on that back marker car. That is one of the Williams. Going into that turn. Well, trying to get around the lap car, Nick DeFries. He messed me up. And Hamilton is in the pit. That is the final pit stop of the day. So, no, I don't have to pin until the next four laps. gets out of the pits because he was trying to get out of the pits in that straight line, because that is a very good straight line going in through there, and he hooked on into P5. Seconds ahead of the tractor stopping. And both tests are, looks like he did the strategy pretty well. He is now running in P3. But he's staying out there because he made the right move of going into the medium tire, so it looks like he's for another pit stop. Yeah, I don't think he's just going to be due for another pit stop because remember, he went with my last piece of strategy, but it only ended up in P3. Seconds ahead of Max Verstappen, running at pretty even speed with the Red Bull car. But it looks like the medium tires are not very equipped here in the Hanoi Circuit. And now both have to do the test, and remember, he's going to go with the soft tire on this last turn of the pit stop, but that means Perez now moves back into P3. So he's only about a second ahead of Lewis Hamilton. Addison and Alvin are still running in fifth place. I think he's going to stay out there. Here in the final 11 laps on the medium tire towards the Vietnamese Grand Prix, 19 seconds ahead. Well, I'm going to be able to have 4 laps pressure tires to max the stop and I'll make this pit stop. Saving that fuel mileage and everything, but we have to make a fast, clean stop, and then when we get out of there, then we can make it straight through. stop it. Good hang up this track. minutes into the race. Already pulling away from her stop at almost about 2.4 seconds. Of the F2 World Tour. The Chinese Grand Prix is their next stop for the F2 World Tour, so we'll be able to do both races, the F2 and the F1 race. The F2 World Tour Championship Series goes to China. Trying to hang on in P4. He won't get a podium out of this, but he's going to get a good fourth place. All I have to do is win this race, and we have 33 points. Well, we have 36 points in our hand. Remaining here at the in the Vietnamese Grand Prix. Oh man, I lost it again. I shouldn't get the break. 1.9 seconds. I lost it again. I think it's able to be timed to use that some of the DRS so we can pull away from the stoppage. Deja vu like last season. Remember last season, Little Calcum was coming up to me and everything, and now this time, extra traffic. 0.7 seconds, he is coming. We don't have any last cars up ahead. Do we have anybody on the gate coming into the hairpin? Oh yeah, we have one up ahead. That's one of the Alfa Romeo cars. That's, I think that's the other Nancy. I pulled away a little bit. We have a 5.5 laps to go, 1.7 second advantage. I do gain a little bit of ground. This has been some great racing so far. But I can't have no more mistakes now. How fast are 2 seconds now. I'm already on the overtake mode right now. I'm just trying to get my boots up faster. Creating your own team is tough. This is not like an ordinary full factory, full base team like Red Bull or Mercedes-AMG or Petronel. It's a Red Bull car. And that's the top of time we come to a four different winners this year here in Formula 1. So it's still trying to hold on. And that's good news to hear. 2 seconds ahead of Max Verstappen. I got plenty of boost on this car. When we get those R&D developments from the Chinese country, it's going to make it a little bit more of a rocket ship. Only 2 seconds ahead of Max Verstappen. Let's see if he can hold on to this position. And we have a lot of car up ahead, and that's the end of Nancy. Let's see if he can give me some help a little bit. 2.3 seconds. Still using that number 3 boost. Well, in 2 seconds, then we use that boost to keep ahead over Max Verstappen. With 3.5 laps remaining here in the Vietnamese Grand Prix. In the last 3.5 laps, we have to run it perfect. And we don't have to worry about Hamilton or Perez or anybody. I hope Perez can stay over in P4. It looks like both sets of tires. We used the top tires in the final set of the race, 23 seconds. See if we can hold on with P4. Laps remaining here at the Vietnam Grand Prix. 3 laps to go. We're now trying to get around to the Nancy. In fact, I got throttle going into the roundabout, the first roundabout sector. And we do have DRS. Thank you very much for using the last car of the Nancy to get that DRS. Thank you. too far down. Looks like they're stopping slow down a little bit as they're getting pressured by some of the other Nancy's. That was the key of the race right there. Using the lap car, I'm telling you, the other Nancy has to pick to keep the dirty pressure going on Max Verstappen. And that was just what I needed right there. Thank you very much, Dia Vinanti. And for something, still can't get around Dia Vinanti. He still can't get around, and he finally gets around Dia Vinanti. And we have two laps remaining. And we finally have our first retirement of the race. And it's George Russell in the Racing Points car, which is going to become Aston Martin next season. So one of the Racing Point cars with a lap and a half to go is now out of the race with a blown motor. And there it is right there. He retired from the other part of the straightaway. What a tough break for George Russell and the Racing Point team. He had a good run going. He was running a P8, and now he has dropped out of the race. There he is right there. And the Verstappen cannot pass under the yellow flag. And Verstappen had all sorts of trouble trying to get around the last part of Dia Vinanti, but that was the key of the race that I needed right there. Able to get enough distance to win this Vietnam Grand Prix, and the next time around is the final lap. And I don't think Verstappen is going to be able to make it. He's 3.4 seconds, and he's still dropping. That was fast, so it was going on to this lap with two laps to go where it had to count. Yeah, Max Verstappen got into the dirty air. It's going to take him a while to get back into the clean there after getting pressured by Pia Vinanti. And next time around, it is the final lap here at the Vietnam Grand Prix. One more lap to go. And I was the fastest car out there with a minute 37.83 in the final lap here at the Vietnam Grand Prix. I had a fantastic race here at the Vietnam Grand Prix, and no mistakes at all here at the Hanoi Circuit this time. I only made two mistakes last season in the final laps of this race. But I don't think Max Verstappen is going to be like Lewis Hamilton, like he did last season. This is a whole totally different story here at the Hanoi Circuit. So now I just need to bring it home. We're 3.2 seconds, but it's too late for Max Verstappen. He is catching up and everything, but it's going to be too little, too late. And we're going to go into risk next. Going around the hairpin corner for the final time, and we're going out risk next. And this one makes a difference. And now around the exit for the final time, we're here at the Hanoi Circuit. And I'm going to hold on to this win with a 3-second advantage over Max Verstappen. And going around the final hairpin for the final drive. And I have done it. I have done it. What a perfect race, perfect showing. And I win the Vietnam Grand Prix for the second season in a row. And that's my second race win in a row for the Team J-Bone. And the driver today goes to Carlos Sainz in the McLaren. What a great job for me and Sergio Perez. Even though Perez didn't get a podium finish, but he ends up in P4, but he did a phenomenal job. What an impressive job by the team and everything. Giving me a great fast race start and fast pit stop. What a nice job. Two races in a row we won, and I won by 6 car lengths in the previous race, but now I won by 3 seconds over Max Verstappen. Where the race is won today. Yeah, that's that's my second season in a row that I won the Vietnamese Grand Prix. What a ride that was. That was an excellent race for me.
Nothing compared to our drivers here. They've worked hard to make it up there. And it's great to see them make their way out onto the podium.
Yeah, a good strong showing by Max Verstappen finishing in second place. And we're going to have to take a look at the highlights to see what really happened to Lewis Hamilton during the first round of pit stops. You know, he got it around me and everything, and then he took the lead. You know, he would have been the guy to win this race. But at least he got a P3.
Fourth place over the lead of the Drivers' Championship. After an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant? Carlos Sainz certainly wasn't someone to talk about. His ability to follow race strategy throughout with pinpoint precision is commended. It's time to check out the constructor's standard. The other Drivers' team moves to the top of the table. Well, Ant, that ends to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us, and we'll see you for the next.
An impressive race in the Hanoi Circuit in our third season. I win the third Vinfast Vietnam Grand Prix, and it was a great race. And then we didn't have the fastest lap. Both guys had the fastest lap in the final because he had the soft tires. But that's okay, but we won it anyway, and we did great. And a good job with Sergio Perez getting a strong fourth place showing. He could have had a podium finish and everything, but Lewis Hamilton, he had the strongest car out there. He did a great job. And let's take a look at the standings here after the Vietnam race, after a great win and our second win of our third season of my Formula One, my team, J-Pro career mode. This was a nice episode, number 47. Even though it wasn't a great battle between me and Verstappen, but he closed in on me, but then that lap car of Giovinazzi really helped me. I gained a lot of ground, and that was a big plus right there. That was the key moment of the race over there in the final lap here. And great job by Giovinazzi, giving a lot of dirty pressure over Max Verstappen. He moves up in the sixth in the standings, and we're now 13 ahead of Lewis Hamilton. And my teammate Perez having a great start so far, P3, and a great start this season. Last year he was in P11, but now he's in P3, and he's doing excellent out there. And he's under 19 ahead of me in the point standings, and both guys are running a fourth. Still a great battle, but now Red Bull is joining into the mix. For this race too, and thanks to them, they break off and actually stop them. And now we're going to go to our highlights of the race, most certainly, because it was an excellent race. And I made no mistakes at all, didn't hit any walls. I almost had a big moment there, almost hitting the wall going into the S's, but I redeemed myself. And look at the start of the race. I had enough room to pass Verstappen and then my teammate Perez, and then I went straight on to the lead. Look at that great battle between me and Hamilton. And the Stars and Stripes car, this is the Star 9/11 edition of our library, honoring 9/11 from yesterday. And we do honor the friends and heroes of what happened 19 years ago. And we're having a little trouble with that camera angle over there. Oh, there we go. A little miscommunication in the camera. Here's that pass for the lead over there going into the long straightaway when we were trying to get around Lewis Hamilton. I think this was the first short straightaway. And there's no contact over there. No, I didn't make contact with Hamilton. And then he got around me again. Let's take a look what happened. Did I make contact with him in this turn? No, I did not make contact with him. It was a clean pass. I had enough race room to get around them, but it looks like those center disc tires kind of lost it. And then I bumped into one of the Alfa Romeo cars, but then I redeemed myself again. And here's the finish of the race. And that was a good margin right there, and a great car right at the end. There's plenty of boost on that car, and plenty of DRS, and the impressive job out there. I don't see any penalties out of anybody or anything. And, hey, good job by the, not a good job for the Ferrari. They're losing ground. Look at that, 9th and 11th. not good, and in real life they're not doing well either. McLaren did good, and the Red Bulls did well too. Good job for Alexander Albon, but he didn't have the pace as both that did. So, let's go in advance. And looks like my video on YouTube is going to go through, and the race is already finished, and that's what counts. And now I have another episode to put on for you YouTube subscribers. You can click into YouTube and check in the description at SpeedChampion83.
How are you feeling after that win?
I'm feeling impressed about that win, and this is our second season in a row that we won the Vietnamese Grand Prix, but even this time it was much better. We had a great car, and the engine was running so well, and I'm happy with my guys and everything. They worked so hard with this car, and we did a great job, and two wins come world for us. And we have that durability development coming up next.
What happened to your race with you during the race?
Yeah, I did. It was at the start of the race. We flew right all the way to fourth, all the way to the lead, and great battles over there with Lewis Hamilton, and then also Max Verstappen during the race. He did a great, very good job out there. Right? It was an awesome car for our start to price paint scheme.
You really were in control of the car right there.
I had a lot of great control. The car handled beautifully out there, and impressive pit stops for the guys and all that, and keeping me into the lead and keeping me ahead, and also giving me a strategy advantage and everything, and the strategy with the stance on the tires. It worked very well out there. And if that's off, this team's able to answer your organization. We're going to win this constructive championship, but we still have a long way to go. But we're going to be on to China and see how we can do there. Well, okay. Well, before we close out our episode number 47 of the Vietnam Grand Prix, what a fantastic performance by the car again. And this time it pulled ahead a little bit. And we also beat our rivalry breakdown on about three both sides. And we're going to really get plenty of boosting going in there. We're still at 21 right now. We're at 18 in our claim right now. We're almost 2 away of 20, and we completed all our accomplishments again. Look at that, $1.88 million so far, and plus a $90,000. And we had a slight bit of damage. I think that was the contact with Hamilton. And look at that, we're up to $17 million, but we're still not making any developments yet until we reach $25 million, and then we could do our spec upgrade, because all the upgrades are all expensive. But we still cannot upgrade our car until we reach 25 million. We're already up to 17 million so far, and the next race is China. And we do have the Rovers and Halo. Well, we get our rotor, and we do get the halo that we needed. So now we have two major upgrades in our car. And we are going to change our livery for the next race. We'll drive the start and stretch car in the Dutch Grand Prix, but we're going to drive a special car for the Chinese Grand Prix for the next race. And don't forget that we have to do our activities. And we do have an invitational event coming up, too. Can't do the invitational event, but now we can do the, we're going to do a chassis development focus. I think we could do, we're going to fund the team event too. We'll work on that, and then also driver promotion filming as well. So those are the three that we'll do on our activities on, and let's see our R&D development. Remember, the durability is back, so we're going to put that in there. Now that we have the halo, now we have a new halo upgrade in the car, and then also we're still waiting on that chassis upgrade. So now we have a C12 right now. wins, we have another ultimate upgrade coming up with that. There's too many high upgrades. Way too many high upgrades coming up, so we'll have to wait until the next one. We do have enough, so we have two new upgrades. Let's see, the next one is going to be the chassis. Now we are leading, we are officially now leading in the performance comparison. Now that we have two big upgrades, we have a major upgrade in the halo, and then now we have an upgrade on the powertrain as well, which is now the rotor. So now we have a new rotor in the car, and that's really going to help us for the Chinese Grand Prix. That is the energy recovery system, so it's going to make the car really fast, and the fuel injection system will be next. And then, well, we'll do the chassis next in the next race. So that will be our main plan for the next race in China. We could do the quicker upgrades if we need to. So that's going to do it for our episode of number 47 of the Vietnam Grand Prix. It was a superb race, a superior top SP. And until then, I hope everyone enjoys the rest of your day, and we'll see you in the next one, the Chinese Grand Prix. So long, everyone. Have a good day, and enjoy your rest, and also enjoy the real race tonight in NASCAR, a different race play. So goodbye and so long, everyone. Everyone have a great day.